What is up, guys? Leo from Golden State Strings here today with the second installment or the second episode of my mini summer series, State Strong. So today for the second episode, we are redoing a woody, refurbishing a woody. There you go. That was the word I was looking for. So far I've got a little bit of it done, and I got this from a thrift store actually. A local thrift store, which is kind of weird because you don't usually find stuff like this at thrift stores on the West Coast. But at this thrift store, I actually found two of them for like $60. And this one was slightly broken up top, so I just put some electrical tape over it. The other one was basically good condition. They're woodies, but they were, I'm pretty sure they're from England because of it's Victoria and stuff. And it just looks like it is. So I actually sold the other one for, I think, $80. And then I got them both for $60. So I actually made money off both of them. And I kept one. So it was basically, there was like plastic in it for the leathers. It was plastic runners. And it was just, it was obviously not what I wanted 100% with a woody. So I decided, this was actually a couple months ago, I just tore everything out. And literally the dust was just coming up into my nose as I was cutting it all out. So now, so far, I've got the sidewall on this side done. And I'm working on finishing up the gut. So I've just started the gut right there. And I'm going to have to finish stringing it. And then I got some polyurethane, as I saw on Joe from Thrones' video. That's what he used for the gut to make it nice and like hard. And so yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. And so far it's looking really good, even though it's basically nothing. I got a little twist on it and everything. So real quick, this video will probably be a little longer than the first episode, but stay tuned because it'll definitely be worth the wait. All right guys, let's go through it. All right guys, out here I have my polyurethane. Don't really know how I'm gonna open it right now, but I'm taking a little help from Joe from Throne and basically doing the same thing with the woody. Here's the gut and everything, so let's get started.
Kids still, tell them hoes come through the breakup. Get to know somebody and you really learn a lot about them. Won't be long before you start to doubt them. Tell yourself you're better off without them. Then in time you will find can't walk without them. Can't talk without them. Can't breathe without them. Came here together, you can't leave without them. So you walk back in, make a scene about them. On your Amory, it's just one thing about them. It's called love. Niggas don't sing about it no more. Don't nobody sing about it no more. No more. It's called love. Niggas don't sing about it no more. Don't nobody sing about it no more. But there a nigga in the club singing.
To the window, to the wall. My nigga ride when I call. Got bitches all in my mind. Fuck nigga blocking my shot. I know the reason you feel no way. I know just who you wanna be. So every day I think the man upstairs. It ain't you and you ain't me. Get off my dick.
So, coat number two is all done. It's looking pretty good right now. It's right outside over there. And I'm gonna leave it there for about an hour. See how that works out. It'll probably be nice and dry by then, even though the polyurethane thing says 3 to 4 hours, which is ridiculous. I'm not gonna wait 4 hours in between every single time I coat it, just because I want it to be, I woke up early this morning so I could do it all in one day, not have it wait there out all night. Also, I just found out I won a giveaway from IL Gear, so thank you to them. You had to follow them on Snapchat, so add them as a friend. Screenshot one of their posts from the Twitter song night. I took a picture of Dylan Malloy because he's just looking kind of ridiculous. He won this year. He was wearing shorts and he was in a little scooter wheelchair thing, and it was just looking kind of ridiculous, but it was funny. I put it up on Instagram, and then they chose me. I don't think a lot of people were in it, but I won a Twerton shaft, which is very limited edition. I think it might be one of the only ones made. It's made by Under Armour, which is pretty cool. And then I think an Under Armour Twerton shirt. So that's a lot, and that's pretty cool. I almost entered their Twitter giveaway. I probably should have, because I could have gotten double. Because I bet you not that many people there entered either. My bad. And That was for some Tweer Tong gloves, which would have been pretty cool. Probably the Under Armour Command ones or whatever. But I'm sidetracking now, so we're going to finish up this project, and I'll take you guys on, and we'll see the stringing next.
Alright guys, so the sound had to be cut out right here because one of the songs was copyrighted and I couldn't put it on. So I'm just going to kind of freeball on this. So basically, this is my Woody. It's strung up with Throne leather, all black. It's got all black crosslays. I used some polyurethane to do the gut. And just like Joe from Throne did. And that's where I kind of got this whole idea for this mini-series and this head, too. I was really thinking about that, and I was like, let's do it. So anyway, I think it's an 8-diamond traditional, a 7 or 8-diamond. And it's really nice, not super symmetrical with the leathers, just because it was a woody. But I used the Tradetree Retro, which helped me out a ton. I just had to throw some chopsticks in it so it was able to fit both sides. So I really like this tie-off right there. That's why I was showing it. And overall, I was really proud of this. Yeah. Nice channel. As I said earlier, the leathers are kind of unsymmetrical, but it still throws extremely nice. I think I mentioned it later, but also I did not put any shooting strings in because I wanted to make more traditional look. So it's just cross lace. And then I just showed the pocket view. It's a nice like mid-high pocket in it. Overall, really, really just looking sleek. It was a little deep, but it shouldn't matter because I really won't be using this in a game because I don't think I can, but yeah. Hold wise, pretty good, not a ton of hold, but extremely low amounts of whip. Not too extreme, but a beginner could basically pick it up and probably throw with it pretty nicely, and so and have a good amount of hold with it. So overall, that's kind of what I was shooting for, and so I guess I got it. Also, that is white sidewall on, I think, the right side. And then I used a white sidewall for the gut, too, and I just put polyurethane over it. And then here I was talking about the Tweer Tong shaft I won earlier. Here it is. It came in the mail by the end of the video. It's really cool. It's from Under Armour. I won it through IL Gear. I took a screenshot of their Snapchat story and then put it on my Instagram page. And so I really like it. It's pretty cool. Nice. I think it's called the SC1X shaft. It's nice, it's metal, I think, and it's not super heavy or anything, and it looks really clean on some of my heads. So, quite honestly, that's about it I can think of right now. So, I guess you can watch the rest of this video in silence if you would like to, but I think there's a good amount of time left. But if you don't, anyway, like this video if you liked it. Subscribe. Oh, hold on, time out. This is where I'm talking about the shooters where it's just cross lace on going across. It's not actual shooting strings because I wanted to make it more of a traditional look, and I also had no black shooters, and I just kind of wanted the all black pocket. So I think this is where I'm starting to say, like this video if you liked it, subscribe if you haven't, follow me on Instagram if you don't already, @GoldenStateStrings, and have a great day.